Hello, my friends! Привет, друзья! Today we'll talk about the question who's Чей? And this is lesson number 11. Let's go! Now let's read the text. I read, you follow me and try to understand everything. Давай читать. This nice word, давай. It means let's read. Давай читать. Вот автобус. Он большой, а не маленький. Он старый, а не новый. This a means opposition. Он желтый. Это школьный автобус. Он твой? Да, я школьник, а это мой автобус. А вот моя школьная форма. Вот. Она белая и зеленая. Моя форма красивая. Это мои хорошие друзья и подруги. Это. Они смелые, красивые и умные. А это мой учитель. Вот. Какая она? Она добрая, умная, а также красивая. Do you remember what также mean? Also. And now I think you already noticed a new word, друзья. Друзья is a plural form for the word друг. Друг, it is exception from the rule and different from every other words. And so, this plural form is друзья. You have to remember it. Here, I want to explain you the difference between давай and давайте. When we talk to one person, we say just давай. And if we talk to two and more people, we add particle те. Давайте, давайте. For example, давай играть. Давайте играть. If I talk to one person, I will say давай рисовать. And if I want to paint with some people in one room together, I will say давайте рисовать. Давай читать. Давайте читать. Давай работать. Давайте работать. But also, you can say давайте when you talk to one person, and it is when you say in polite form, when you address to a person вы, for example, if you talk to a teacher or to someone who is older than you, and you say давайте. And some more examples of this particle те with the word здравствуй. I already told you about it. Здравствуй, when you talk to one person. Здравствуйте, when you talk to two and more people. And also, здравствуйте is a polite form. Здравствуй, бабушка. Здравствуйте, дети. Дети means children. Дети. Дети. It is a regular form of plural. Also, we don't have the word дети. We have the word ребенок is one child and children дети. But today I want you to remember only this word дети. Здравствуйте, Татьяна. Here Татьяна is one person, but I add the particle те to make it polite. Здравствуйте, Татьяна. In Russian, здравствуйте means be healthy. And it is also hello. Every time Russians say hello, they wish health to each other. For example, look here at these words. Здоровье means health. Здравствуй. Be healthy. Здоровье, здравствуй. Do you hear some similar sounds? Здоровье, здравствуй. And this is the main part of today's lesson. This is a wonderful table. You have to print it out from your computer because it is very easy to just to look up in it and find the correct word when you do some exercises. I hope that you do some exercises also. And these are words to express whose. Чей for masculine, чья feminine, чьё neuter, чьи plural. And you can see those endings. Y, it is ending for masculine, я ending for feminine, your ending for neuter, and e ending for plural. It is easy if you know those endings. This is the base of Russian grammar, I already told you, and you have to remember those endings. Let's do some examples. Это класс. Класс is a classroom and a group of people. Чей он? Это наш класс. Наш. It is here. Наш класс. Класс is masculine, so our. Here is the example how to use this table. Это друзья. Чьи они? You can see друзья, чьи они. It is all plural. Это наши друзья. So we use plural form of our. It is here. Наши. Это стул. Чей он? Это мой стул. Here. Мой. Это стол. Чей он? Это твой стол. Твой here. Стул is a chair. Стол is a table. These are the new words. Стул, стол. They are pretty easy. Repeat after me. Стул, стул, стул. In English, we have the word stool, which means almost like, almost a chair, you know. It is easy to remember. And стол, стол, стол. It's also so easy to remember. And this one, what is this? It's a map. Это карта. Карта. Чья она? You can see this is ending of feminine. Ending of feminine. Это ваша карта. So, if you want to say it is your map, we must use this form. Это ваша карта. Вы. And your, ваша. Это окно. Окно. Also a new word. Окно. This О is like А because it is not stressed. Окно. The stress is on the second О. Чье оно? Это ваше окно. Это ваше окно. And here are some more examples. Это Иван и Тамара. Иван, Тамара. Тамара его жена. Жена is a wife. Тамара его жена is his wife. Его. When you want to say его, his, it is all the same in all genders and in plural form. It is easy. Его. Иван ее муж. Иван is her husband. Husband. Иван ее муж. Ее is also the same in all forms. It is so easy. I love easy Russian. А твоя семья большая? Твоя Семья большая. Иван чей муж? Чей муж? Он ее муж. Тамара чья жена? Она его жена. Чьи это дети? Дети, children. Чьи это дети? Они их дети. They are their children. Их is the same in all forms as well. So, now you know that his, her and their is the same in all forms. You have to remember only one form. Его, ее, их. And here are some more examples, because when you see examples, you better understand the rule. And we have four columns here. First one for masculine. Masculine words end in consonants. It is the rule and you know it. Second one for feminine. Feminine words end in -ая. Third column for neuter words. Neuter words end in -ое-ё. And plurals. Plurals end in -и-ы. И-ы. And here, down here, there is example of how to form the question with the word whose, чья. You can put word это in the beginning or after the word чья. But also, you can skip this word at all. You can skip it and not use it at all, and you will still have the same meaning. Let's look at this at the first column for the masculine form. Чей это компьютер? Чей это чей папа? So here we said чей это компьютер, and here we said это чей папа. So we put it on the different place, this word это, and the meaning is the same, and both examples are correct. And in the third example, we just skipped it and we said чей паспорт, and it is also correct. Чей паспорт, чей папа, чей компьютер, чей это компьютер, это чей компьютер. All these examples are correct and you can use any of them. And when you answer the question, you can use это, or you can use он, она, оно, они for masculine, feminine, neuter and plural. Then you have to choose some of these words. Мой, твой, моя, твоя, его, ее, whose, whose is this? And then add the noun. Then you add the noun which we ask about. But in this case, when you answer, you can skip both these parts. Это, он, and noun. You can skip it and say only whose, only one word. Look at the examples to understand it better. Чей это компьютер? Он мой. Чей это папа? Это его папа. Чей паспорт? Ее паспорт. Чья это книга? Это твоя книга. Чья это мама? Моя. Only one word. Моя. Чья школа? Наша. You see? And it is all correct. You can see any variations of these words. Чье это радио? Это их радио. Чье это окно? Оно ваше. Чье пианино? Оно наше. Чьи это карандаши? Ее. Чьи это подруги? Мои. Чьи это друзья? Они его друзья. So, you can skip the word это. You can skip the word он, она, оно, они. and you can skip noun in the answer. Yes, if you don't want to skip, you can say full answer. Чей это компьютер? Это мой компьютер. Чья это книга? Это моя, твоя книга. Чье это радио? Это мое радио. If it is easier for you, of course. But if it is easier to skip, do it. Выучи слова. Чей, чья, чье, чьи. Наш, наша, наше, наши. Ваш, ваша, ваше, ваши. Его. Ее. Класс. Стол. Стул. Карта. Дети. Муж. Жена. Давай. Молодцы. That's all for today. До свидания, мои друзья. Goodbye, my friends. Спасибо за внимание. Thank you for your attention. Пока-пока. Bye-bye.